Hi, I'm Daniel Segal, Senior Care Advisor at Total Senior. I want to talk to you about the steps of moving your loved one into a senior living community. The first step is simple. You need to talk to someone about what's going on in your particular family and what options might exist that can provide the care within budget in the right location for your loved one. After the initial intake, you'll be given some options that you can start touring. When you're touring communities, you want to explore all the aspects of life that are important. It's not only about the care, it's also about the food, the other residents that your loved one will be engaging with, the responsible administrative staff that'll be overseeing the operations, the caregivers that'll be providing the day-to-day care, the activity calendar to make sure that there are the right aspects of life that your loved one will find important and valuable to them, to find interest, to live with a purpose. Quality of life is important. And so you need to look at all of these aspects of life to make sure that you're finding the right fit. Once you've visited a handful of communities, it might be 3, it might be 23, however many it is, do your due diligence. The worst case scenario is that you've seen too many. But I'd rather you see too many than make the wrong decision by not seeing enough and have to restart this entire process, uplift your loved one, and move them again. So as you're touring communities, narrow down the list based on the parameters you've set for your requirements of what you're looking for. Once you narrow that list, you might want to include your loved one who will be living there to show them a couple options and let them make the final decision. Don't overwhelm them with 10 options. Narrow it down to just a couple that'll really make sense for them. Let them make that final decision. Perhaps visiting during lunch or dinner would be the best time so that your loved one or even you can see who else lives there, what the food looks like, and it would be smart to even see what the food tastes like. Maybe stay for an activity after dinner or after lunch or before and see what the lifestyle is like. Go through the building, see the available apartments, and find the one that you like most. You still need to negotiate the specific deal to the rent. The base rate in some cases can be negotiable. The care costs are typically fixed. The community fee in each community may be negotiable depending on circumstances. We can always help with that part of it as well. The next step would be completing an admission agreement with management, having your doctor prepare what's known as a physician's report, or you'll commonly hear it called a 602 form. It's a standard form where a doctor will just specify what it is that the individual moving into the community requires assistance with. They'll document the primary or secondary diagnosis. They'll mention whether there is cognitive impairment that exists, and they'll classify whether an individual is capable of performing certain activities of daily living on their own or what they need assistance with day to day. Once you've completed all the paperwork, left a deposit, and scheduled a move-in date, you need to pick what you're gonna move. You wanna make this new apartment your loved one's home. This is their home. Make it comfortable, make it theirs. Bring the pictures from their home. Put a bunch of holes in the walls and hang their pictures so they can see their family members. Let them see themselves 30, 40 years ago. Set them up with the things that are gonna make them smile. Bring their favorite TV with the remote control that they know how to use so they're not confused by it. Bring their favorite chair. Bring their comfortable mattress and their bed frame. Bring their favorite dresser. Bring their clothes. You can either do all this yourself or you can hire a move manager. Move managers specialize in senior relocation. They can do as much or as little as you like. They can simply function as a moving company. Some of them can give you really cool guides and keys with colored post-its that you can mark certain furniture and items in your loved one's home to choose what's going into their new apartment and what's not. Sometimes they have legends and maps where they put out the dimensions of your new apartment and let you put the bed and the dresser and the chair and all the areas. So they'll pack everything up for you. And by the time you move your loved one, their entire apartment is set up exactly the way you wanted it, possibly even looking exactly like their previous apartment they used to live in. These are all important steps to make this a stress-free transition into a community. Early on, you may want to visit them a little bit more often to make sure they know that they haven't been abandoned. Stop by just to see them, have lunch with them, have dinner with them. Maybe stay, watch a movie with them. Help them unpack a few extra things in their apartment. Help them find things in their apartment that maybe aren't exactly where they used to be. This is their new home. Help them make it their home. Please feel free to call us and learn about all these steps that go into making this transition as smooth and stress-free as possible for yourself and your loved ones. We'll look forward to talking to you.